is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we are back yet again with some brand new WWE action figure reveals for you guys. If you guys missed yesterday's video where we got some reveals from day one of Ringside Fest, definitely go check out day one of Ringside Fest reveals if you guys missed out on that video. But coming back today, man, we have day number two of Ringside Fest. I felt like today's spirits were a lot better compared to yesterday, but the chat was still running wild. The chat was going insane, man. They were unhappy with things. I don't know, maybe that's just how online, you know, chats are, or at least live chats are for these reveal videos. I'm not sure. It just seemed like, I don't know, it got kind of crazy in there. But let's go ahead and dive into the reveals, man. We have to start off with this figure right here. I have to start off with the new WrestleMania Elites Vince McMahon Build-A-Figure Wave. And I'm starting off with this HBK, man, WrestleMania 26. How beautiful is this right here, man? This is actually HBK's last match, if you don't include that god-awful one in Crown Jewel with The Undertaker and Triple H. And we have been waiting on this gear forever, right? I mean, we had the defining moments, WrestleMania 25, HBK, but getting a WrestleMania 26 HBK here, his final matchup, double-jointed arms. The head sculpt is the same head sculpt that was on the WrestleMania 25. This is basically a re-release of that figure, except it doesn't have the hat or the trench coat, but it does have double-jointed arms. It is a long pants HBK that we have been waiting on for so very long, man. So to finally get this HBK is amazing. You know, it's not the mid-2000s Ruthless Aggression era HBK, but it's still a beautiful looking HBK. We've been waiting on some more long pants HBKs, and this is beautiful to have another Shawn Michaels in the long pants, an iconic moment, double jointed arms. This is going to be my favorite Shawn Michaels maybe to date that they've done. It's going to be close. We'll have to see about that at the end there. Maybe we'll get like an ultimate edition of a Ruthless Aggression era HBK. That would be really sick to see. You know, they're already coming out with another one. Maybe we'll get a long pants version with that. But I had to show this figure off. It's beautiful. I love this. This may be my favorite from today. We'll have to see at the end there. But that was beautiful. Next up in the set, guys, is AJ Styles. Now, this figure right here is kind of boring to me. Wasn't big on this figure. Same head sculpt from Elite 74, which is almost 20 series ago. I don't know if they adjusted the jeans height. It may be the same height as every other jean mold, which is going to bother me a little bit. He should be a little bit shorter. He's not as tall as Dean Ambrose, so hopefully that will be the case. We'll have to see about that. However, you know, it is from the Boneyard match. We'll get the other side of that, you know, Elite 85 Undertaker, which is cool. But not the best figure ever. Kind of a plain Jane. I could see this thing rotting on shelves for sure. But we'll have to see about that. You know, it's an interesting release. Would have liked to seen a new head sculpt or a better attire, but I understand it. You get, you know, cloth t-shirt, which is really awesome. You get the shovel and everything, but let's move on to the next figure. We have WrestleMania 19 Stone Cold Steve Austin. Now, you'll say this is just another Stone Cold Steve Austin, but this is a perfect figure to put in here. They give you the pissed off head sculpt from the Ultimate Edition. You do have the pinless arm joints there, which are, I don't know if I like them or not, you know, just because it just kind of depends on, you know, what you're going for there. If you want to do swaps and stuff, I guess it doesn't matter on all figures, but the Stone Cold looks sick. This is his last matchup ever, and it is it's pretty cool because him and Shawn Michaels are both, this is both of their last matches ever, not counting Crown Jewel. But the Stone Cold looks sick. This is very iconic and nostalgic for me. I honestly kind of want to get a Stone Cold Steve Austin collection mop, and this may be one that I have to add to that list, man. Really sick. It doesn't have the words on the back. Pretty sure on the back it's supposed to say bulletproof, if I'm remembering correctly, and I guess they just couldn't put bulletproof on the back. They can't put bullet, I guess, for whatever reason. Makes no sense to me. They can't write the word bullet, but they can give figures guns. Makes no sense. Moving on from the Stone Cold, really like the Stone Cold Steve Austin, though. I'm a huge Stone Cold Steve Austin fan. One of my favorites of all time, so I'll pick up any of them. I'm all for another Stone Cold Steve Austin. And the last figure in the set, kind of a bummer as well. It is a re-release of the Bret Hart. Now, they came out and said this isn't a re-release, but this is actually straight up a re-release, bro. This is a re-release. I know they changed some few things around, but it's the same leg molds. You got a slightly different t-shirt, if I'm not mistaken. I own this figure somewhere, and the head sculpt is pretty much identical. He does have elbow pads. He has pink wrist tape, which I think was white wrist tape last time. But this is a straight up re-release, man. This is a straight up re-release. It may have double jointed arms and stuff, but it's still a re-release figure, man. They updated it a little bit, but it's a re-release. Like, I at least in my opinion, that is what a re-release is. This looks like a re-release to me. Kind of a Bret Hart. Still not my favorite there. It looks identical to the other one, so that's kind of a mess. But that is your WrestleMania Build-A-Figure set, and you can build a young Vince McMahon, which is pretty cool. You got the suited body with the bow tie. You are going to get the three-count hand, which is really cool. You can put that with your referees or something, maybe, when you're doing pick-fed or stop-motion matches. Maybe for your setup, you can plug in that three hand. So you can have your three-count for your matches or whatever. But the full wave is you know, I like the HBK. I like the Stone Cold. The Bret Hart, at least it's not, like, the exact same figure. They do give you a couple different things there. And then the AJ Styles is what it is. I would have liked liked to see a different AJ there, but it is cool. It is cool. You'll be able to do the glove pose much easily with him, but that is the WrestleMania Build-A-Figure Vince McMahon wave. Outside of that, man, we did have some brand new figures shown off to us. We got new images of the Ultimate Edition Ultimate Warrior, which is the second Ultimate Warrior that we're getting here. You guys can see these different images. Now, some of these images may be a little bit blurry. I apologize for that, but I did want to plug these in the video just so you guys could see. You get two championships there. This is a re-release again of the Legends Elite, and then wasn't this also, like, I think this is the third time we're getting this look, if I'm not mistaken. It could be the second time, but I know it was in that Lost Legends set, but it's cool you get the two championships. But it's a Warrior, not a big Warrior guy, but the figure does look cool, and that is excellent. I may have the review for you guys coming next week, so stay tuned for that. But outside of the Ultimate Warrior, man, we actually have a really sick wave of Legends right here, man. Let's get into the next Legends wave. I think this is Legends 13 or 14. We have Edge from this set, man. Look at this throwback Edge. I think they said 2002 Edge. Look at this sick-ass red coat that comes with this Edge figure. You have the white gear. You have a great-looking head sculpt. This is sick, man. Like, I mean, could they have used a different torso? Maybe. They always give Edge this torso, so it's kind of irrelevant at this point. But I'm glad they went with a throwback Edge. I mean, I would have been for any of his rated R gears, but I like that we're getting a different kind of era of Edge here. And you get a Chase variant version. So we're getting a white version and a red version. They both come with the red trench coat. Really sick trench coat, man. That trench coat is sick as hell. You can put that on a lot of different guys. Comes with the sunglasses. I love this Edge figure. I think it looks amazing. Outside of Edge in this set, guys, we also have Mean Mark Callis. So this is actually the first Mark Callis figure we've ever gotten in any company, I'm pretty sure, is what Bill said. So to have this before he was The Undertaker with this epic head sculpt and the way this figure looks is sick as hell. This will look great up on your Undertaker shelf as kind of a transition from that, and that will be excellent. So Mean Mark Callis looks sick. He gets some cloth goods and stuff. That'll be a really cool figure for sure. I think it looks great from what I'm seeing. This Legends wave is actually pretty damn good, man. I think they picked up the quality of this set really, really well. So you have Edge, you have Mean Mark Callis, which looks really sick. Two bonafide stars in the set. And then we also have two DX members. And I apologize if these figures look a bit blurry, and I don't have multiple angles. They only showed us like a couple pictures of each. So here is Road Dogg. He has his army gear on. We already knew we were going to get the full DX and army gear. And then you have Chyna, who I don't think was pictured with her army pants on. At least I don't think so. But you have both of these. They look pretty cool as well. And they said that Road Dogg's gear is going to be his debut gear underneath. So it gives you kind of a different look there. So he's going to be shirtless. I don't think any hand tape or anything. And then he has like his baggy pants on that Road Dogg liked to wear. And then you have the Chyna figure. So I like this full wave. I think the whole Legends wave looks sick. Maybe it's Legends Series 14 if I'm not mistaken, but really great looking wave. I like the wave a lot. I think we're going to get some great usage out of this. I love the red trench coat on Edge and everything like that. But outside of the Legends figures, we do have another look at some upcoming Elite figures. Now, starting out first, guys, we have Austin Theory right here. And Austin Theory, I like the formula they went with. Thank God they didn't go with the damn John Cena-esque torso. I was really afraid they were going to go, like, super-duper jacked here, but I think this works for him. He is in his, like, Johnny Gargano, you know, tag team or faction-inspired gear, and it looks sick. I like the way this figure looks. I'm not a big Austin Theory guy, but the figure looks cool, and I think it'll fit in nicely here. I think he's a part of Elite 93, if I'm not mistaken, so that'll be a really cool figure right there. Again, not a big fan of the guy, but his action figure does look cool. Hopefully, he doesn't rot on shelves because he kind of looks a little plain Jane, but maybe the figure will be really awesome, and maybe he'll be on ball joints and stuff for posability. But outside of that, guys, we have Sami Zayn. Now, we have one render image, and we have one loose figure image that Bill had, and the only gripe I have about this figure is the boots. See, they gave him the Sergeant Slaughter slash, you know, Colonel Mustafa legs, and since they did that, they had to give him tall boots, so the boots are really, really tall. It's like the Macho Man mold, which I do not like, but I do understand why they would give him those pants. I figured this is how they would do it, and it looks amazing. Figure looks great. I love the jacket. I love the hat. I love the Sammy Award. Like, dude, this is a really, really great figure. Going to be a contender for Figure of the Year, probably, when it's all said and done. But I do not like that they gave him the tall boots, but I understand it, you know? Like, completely understandable, but at the same time, also terrible. I'm just kidding, but seriously, though, great-looking head sculpt. Figure looks phenomenal, and you couldn't mention Sami Zayn without his man, Kevin Owens, man. Look at this KO. You guys know I'm a massive KO fan, so seeing this figure here is insane. I love the way this figure looks. Absolutely phenomenal. I love the Stone Owen stun. You got a longer, thicker beard there, white wrist tape. We do get a ladder with this guy, and it's going to be breakaway. And they gave him the handcuffs from the match with Roman Reigns, which is crazy because I swear to God that was yesterday, but it's probably a year ago now. So that's just freaking impossible. But breakaway ladder, beautiful looking KO with the blue Laces in the boots. Great looking figure in hand as well. So I'm really excited for that one. And then we also got revealed the attire for our Chase RVD figure. They even brought RVD on the stream there, and it is his WrestleMania 23 gear. So not my favorite gear ever, but it's still pretty cool. I like that, you know, we're getting a WrestleMania gear. I would have liked to seen WrestleMania 21 where he won the Money in the Bank briefcase, but this is still cool. I like this a lot. You know, maybe we can get like a ring. Since like RVD is back, we have Tiger Stripes, we have WrestleMania 23. Why not do a ringside exclusive? This is the perfect time to give us the ringside exclusive RVD with the Money in the Bank briefcase, with the RVD and the Mr. Money in the Bank airbrush style on there, with the ECW Championship and the WWE Championship, and even maybe an Intercontinental Championship. Like, how sick would that be? What if they did an Ultimate Edition like that with all the belts and bells and whistles? Like, God in heaven, man. One can dream. You guys remember that Deluxe Aggression Stone Cold Steve Austin they released way back in the day? How sick was that figure? Just give me something like that with RVD, with all the different accessories and hands and head sculpt, and God in heaven, what a mock figure that would be, Bradley. But yeah, man, the RVD looks great. He even had an image in hand. It looks really awesome. Can't wait to see what the Tiger Stripes gear looks like. So I think that pretty much wrapped up all the reveals. I don't think we had any other reveals today. Not like the most exciting day again, but I don't know. Do you guys think that that day one was better, or do you guys think that day two was better? You guys can let me know down in the comment section below. But outside of this, we had some like Stretch Armstrong stuff and, you know, some things like that. But damn, bro, I'm excited for these figures. You know, not a perfect day whatsoever. However, you know, we got some pretty good stuff here that I'm excited about, and hopefully, you know, things will continue to get better. I should have Elite Series 90 coming in. I didn't even upload images of Elite Series 90. If you guys want a video detailing those, I could do that for you, but I feel like they're about to be at my door any day, so that could be a thing as well. And I thought about even doing individual reviews for all of Elite Series 90. Would you guys rather do single-hand reviews where one figure gets all the focus, or would you guys rather see the two-in-ones continue there? Let me know down in the comment section below. Maybe if they're a tag team, I could do the tag teams together. But if they're an individual wrestler like a Randy Orton or something, should I cover them alone? You guys can let me know down in the comment section below. But that does it for Ringside Fest, day number two of reveals. I thought it was a solid day. I feel like overall it was better than day one. I love the Edge. I love the HBK. Love the Stone Cold Steve Austin, the Kevin Owens, the Sami Zayn, the RVD. I say that, yeah, day two was definitely better, guys. But you guys can be the judges down in the comment section below. I still think I'm going to have my Freddy and Pennywise first round matchup going up later today. Tomorrow we're going to have both semifinals matchups going on. Halloween night, I think I'm going to premiere that. But anyways, guys, I'm getting out of here. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok at MyDamnToys. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you, and don't cross the line like the Ringside Collectibles chat. You crossed the line. I've been beaten. Boom.